NFL playoffs, and we all sat here watching the final minutes of this game. John Anderson, Michael Lee's alongside, dumbfounded but excited at the same time.
Emphasis to some degree on dumb. AFC East Saturday in the playoffs. Bills go first, Patriots second, and we head right back to Houston for the Ram Trucks post-game report. Booger McFarland isn't afraid to keep working past triple zeros into overtime. He's with us now on SportsCenter. Booger, I don't know if Deshaun Watson qualifies as a question, but I'll give it to you anyway. Deshaun Watson? Really, just gush on him and what he meant to winning this football game.
Well, I think if you go back to when he was at Clemson, and Dabo Sweeney told us, hey, man, this guy's the closest thing I've seen to Michael Jordan on the football field, and everybody just kind of... And then he comes to the NFL, and we've seen it time and time and time again. And when you got two guys blitzing at you full speed, and both of them hit you, and you don't move, and then you make the play to set up the game-winning field goal, I think that just epitomizes what Deshaun Watson is about. Last year, they were down 21-0 to the Colts. He couldn't bring them back. Today, they were down 16-0, and you saw the will of a young man that said, you know what? Let's be great. And why not me? That's the text message he sent to his teammates earlier in the week. Let's be great. And he was great tonight, and great in the most crucial situations in the second half when everybody around the country was saying the same thing. Same old Texans. They get into the postseason. They play on ESPN on Saturday afternoon, and they lay an egg. Well, Deshaun Watson said, you know what? The buck stops here, and he did one hell of a job in the second half. And you got to give Bill O'Brien a lot of credit also because the second half adjustments they made, putting the ball in Watson's hand, bringing DeAndre Hopkins on a lot of crossing routes, and upping the tempo a little bit really changed this game.
Let's talk about how this game got into overtime, because it seemed to me the last few minutes there was some questionable coaching things going on. You had McDermott not punt on 4th and 27. You had Bill O'Brien not 4th and 1 go for a field goal. How did you view those?
Well, I just got to think that these coaches are going with their gut feeling. And yeah, you can go back and you can second guess and question it. But when you're a coach and you're in these playoff moments and you're trying to put your team in the best position that you can to win a football game, yeah, hindsight is always 20/20. Mm-hmm. Maybe now you look back and you say, yeah, maybe we should have punted. But either way, the game gets into overtime. They set up the game-winning field goal, them being Buffalo. They kick it. So no harm, no foul there. And in overtime, they were able to go back and forth, and then Deshaun Watson made a play.
If I'm Buffalo, what part of this is going to eat at me through the rest of the offseason?
I think the first half. They had a chance in the first half to put this game away. Houston had no business being in this game after halftime because they were dominated in the first half. I think if you're Buffalo, you're going to go back and you're going to say, how come we couldn't put it away? Why did we have to settle for so many field goals in the first half? And I think that's going to eat at them. And then on defense, just making tackles. How many times did the Bills, this defense that doesn't give up big plays because they miss tackles, especially there in overtime?
Booger McFarland, 5 quarters of work in this one. Thanks very much. Go get ready for the Pro Bowl, man.
I appreciate it. Thank you, John.
Wow. Yeah, a lot of things to consider here. So we brought in reinforcements. Dan Orlovsky, Jeff Satter. You should have heard the commentary that we were having as the game was transpiring. But let's show you the final 4th minute quarters and the overtime, because a lot happened before then, but it doesn't really matter because right now it's 19-16 Texans. Instead of going for a field goal to make it a 6-point game, they go for 4th and 1 with the Deshaun Watson sneak. Doesn't get it. The Bills get the ball back. So now, Dan, Josh Allen trying to lead that comeback effort. We've seen him make plays with his legs, but what is this right here?
Well, Josh Allen, this is he got bailed out because this is a bad play. You've got plenty of time on the clock. You can just go down. He's trying to ladder it to his tight end. That's a great play by Knox to make sure that that ball gets tapped out of bounds. Josh Allen got bailed out there.
And then Allen here to Cole Beasley near the first down line. Now, Sean McDermott says this is a first down. We need a first down because if not, they've got to kick it because it'd be 4th down. Can we get a decision here? You take a look. Where was the knee? Where was the contact? They would review it. They would get the first down. So 10 seconds ago, Steven Hauschka on for a game-tying field goal from 44 yards away. Good. We go to overtime. So the Texans got the ball first, but they go 3 and out. So now it's 3rd and 12 for the Bills. Allen looking for Knox. Jeff trying to make some time and finds a play.
Now, unbelievable. Sees on the sideline, makes a play. Knox puts his head down, goes, gets the first down. Keeps the chains moving, baby.
Now it's 3rd and 9. Allen rolling to his right. Going to throw across his body. to Devin Singletary. How did he see him? How did he make that play?
This is Josh Allen has some freak show in him. Just a big athlete that can move around a little bit. Always keeps the play alive, found Singletary.
So here is 30-24 after penalty. Not a great pass there. Incomplete, fourth down. Texans get another shot. 3rd and 18. And look at Deshaun Watson make a play, finding Duke Johnson. Where was the defense, Jeff?
You can't do it. They're talking about soft zone, playing 25, 30 yards deep. You got to rally, make the tackle. Can't give up the first down.
But look at Deshaun Watson avoid two potential tackles on that sack. Gets out and completes a huge play to Tywan Jones.
I've watched football for a long time. Deshaun Watson is going to see pressure. He's going to realize I don't have anybody. I've never seen a play that ridiculous. A two-on-one play by Deshaun Watson. Booger mentioned it. Dabo Swinney called him Michael Jordan type. This is a Michael Jordan type player. Can you as a player overcome everything that's around you to be absolutely special?
Are you Buffalo Bills? You're sick, bro. Yeah. There's no excuse not to have two guys. Get one guy down. Come on, man.
So instead of trying to go for a touchdown, Bill O'Brien's like, you know what? We've had enough today. Let's bring on the kicker. Let's get out of here with this win. 22-19 is the final in overtime. Take a look at what happened because, again, the Texans were down 16-0, and you see what Deshaun Watson did after his squad was down 16-0. Those 13 for 14, two touchdowns, ran for one, and threw for another one as his team comes all the way back, gets the win, and moves on to the divisional round. So much to say about this particular game. But again, as we just saw in that highlight, Dan, we're going to be talking about that escape from Deshaun Watson for quite some time. The signature moment so far of his young career.
Freakazoid play. You know the saying, big players make big plays in big time moments. And I've watched football a long time and I've never seen anything like this. Deshaun Watson's in an empty look, right? So he's got everybody spread out for him, empty package. And what Buffalo's going to do is they're going to blitz everybody. They're going to go blitz, 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 blitz. They're going to bring seven guys, okay? Well, Houston only has six guys included in their protection. So Watson knows, all right, ball's got to come out. Everybody is playing man-to-man coverage. He knows I got to get the ball out before they get home to me. But there's a little bit of detail in this play. This is a little bit of freakazoid right here. Okay, Watson's got his hand off the football. He's ready to get that ball out of his hands to some receiver. The guy right here, Jones, he's running an 8-yard stop route. But Deshaun realizes, man, I don't like his body lean right now. I don't like the leverage. Something's not right. I'm going to fast forward. Look it. Jones is starting to slip right now. Deshaun Watson is just in the back end of him trying to think, can I get this ball out? Remember, this is a freakazoid play. He tucks it because he realizes Jones is about to slip down. I don't want to put the ball at risk. And then this happens. I have absolutely no idea how a human being gets out of that when there's two guys on your one if you're Deshaun Watson. But he does because he's a special player. Spins out of it, but I also love this.
Yep.
This is greatness right here where you can get out of that absolute chaos. Two dudes about to take you down, and you keep your eyes downfield to find Jones. Not only that, gives him an accurate throw on the sideline. Doesn't lead him out of bounds. Accurate throw on the sideline, and then Jones does the rest. I've said it before. I've watched football a long time, and you ask yourself sometimes the quarterback's like, what makes guys elite, right? What makes guys worth money? Yeah. You can't put a price on plays like that because
exactly right.
Deshaun Watson in a moment is dead. He's dead.
Yeah.
And if you're the Buffalo Bills, you're like, we just made the great play call. And because he has this sixth sense to see that guy slipping, tucks the ball down, not only doesn't do that, but then makes an outstanding play on top of it. That's special football by Deshaun Watson.
Yeah, bailed out a great defensive call and bailed out his coaching staff from the bonehead plays earlier in the game.
Wow.
No doubt.
I think bonehead is a little severe now. only on one side, the winning side, everybody's a genius.
That's
losing
right.
Side, yes. They have the questions to ask. We like the winning side. We're going to go back out to Houston. DeAndre Hopkins, a champion in this game, gets to move on to the playoffs next week. And DeAndre, first, what's your heart rate? I don't know if you got a pulse on it for me, but what's your heart rate right now after this thing?
Oh, man, you know, it was pretty, you know, it was up there, man. But, you know, it's calmed down now. Now turn the page, you know, quick game coming up next week. So, you know, it's simmered down now.
Okay, so we're all marveling at the escape of Deshaun Watson on that last play. He gets away, he throws. Did you get to see any of that? Because you're out there in the pattern, right?
Man, I didn't see too much. I saw him look like he was going down. And, you know, I saw him come up out of it and make a great play. You know, after looking at it, I looked on the screen and seeing what he did. That's Deshaun.
That's your reaction when you saw it? We're all here gushing over and you saw it. That's just Deshaun? That's a simple explanation?
And that's Deshaun. You know, that's what he does for, you know, for a living, man. He's a great player. in great situations like that, make great plays with his feet, throwing the ball. I don't know how many quarterbacks can do that.
We've taken a count, not many. But he's one of 53. And what was it about the 53 guys? You're down 60-0 and stagnant. What ignited the team and got you going?
Being down, knowing that it's our last 30 minutes, possibly that we're going to be on this field playing football. So I think that right there was enough to motivate us.
And defensively, what'd you think? J.J. Watt comes back and they stood up when they had to.
That's J.J. J.J. gives this whole team hope. From coming back from his injury to coming out here making plays, fighting to the last second. Well, that's J.J. Watt, and I think everybody played off his energy tonight.
All right, we're not sure where you're headed next, but good luck next week. DeAndre Hopkins, Texans winners tonight in overtime against the Buffalo Bills.
Wow. You would think he'd be a little more excited, but again, that is also DeAndre Hopkins, though. He's kind of a chill dude, though.
Yeah.
But, Jeff, to his point, what John was saying, to be down 16-0 like that and rally, what does that say about that squad?
Listen, man, and you saw J.J. ignited that, and you saw the passion before he went in, why he was playing for these moments, for him to set that thing off. Even in the third quarter when he started making plays, everybody rallied around it. Just incredible, incredible performance.
All right, we got another game, but we also got basketball right now. Duke-Miami, ACC. We'll see you at 10 o'clock.